What's good? It's your boy Snee here, and we got Ultimate Team Gameplay. I usually don't bring this throughout the week to Weekend League, but we made some upgrades. I'm plopping them on the screen. Plop. And as you see, we got Derwin, Chase Young, and Rodney Hudson new to the team. So we wanted to test them out. It's the first game with them, so we'll see how they do. Hopefully we can get high impact from Chase Young and Derwin James, but we'll see. If you haven't subscribed, smash that like button, and let's get to the gameplay. Peace.
Jason Sanders now to get this one started, and off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And then he got down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. And now the Chargers are going to look up here and signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Back to throw. Gannon.
Yay!
Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And got his man complete. And he is finally out of bounds, just shy of the 5, all the way down at the 6. A huge play there right off the bat. 76 yards. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. They'll run with Sanders, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown run, and the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone, they do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves, sticking it in the end zone on a running play.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Nothing free! Nothing free!
Down. It's Alexander. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. Shotgun now for Rodgers. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. Now it's Rodgers.
So I missed.
Takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Give him 30 yards there. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10.
Get over here!
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. That's sacked by Khalil Mack.
because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Complete. Jefferson the target. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down. On third down, Alexander. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. They'll try to move aside. It's Alexander, and this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage.
It looks like they quit hitting the snooze button on their alarm there. Finally a sign of life from this defense. They've been fairly passive on this opening drive. Now able to stand up on first and goal. And they sent that play backwards.
Come here!
And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
It hasn't been a real good start to this game from a defensive perspective, but now after the incompletion on second down, things may be changing. If they can come up with one more play, they might be able to get out of it with just a field goal attempt.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
The kick by Sanders is good, and they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Parker, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find one to get you into the end zone and get you six?
The lane opens here. He's past the 30. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw.
Not.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is caught inside the 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Randy Moss, 50 yards. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly for 6. Kick is good. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. Charger football to start quarter number 2 as they've got it with a first and 10. The Charger drive about to get going. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not on that joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
And maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. Now a pass is taken in by Hill. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 25 yards there on the catch and run. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 44-yard line. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. Gets this one to Hill. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback can be deflected. deflection if you miss might be bigger and lead to an interception.
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. Forced out to his left. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. Rodgers now on first down. This one brought in by Jefferson. And he's going to get a solid gain of nine before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Earlier this half, you were wondering how the defense was going to handle him defensively. Were they going to bottle him up at different levels, so to speak, is what you said. What have you seen so far?
Well, I think they've been absolutely terrific because it feels like on every play, if we're watching this in the film room, when you clicked off the film or stopped it, you would see 11 shirts of that same color right there in the frame trying to tackle it. That's what you're looking for.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And it's caught. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll run with Mostert. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. And taking it in for a yard out. And the Chargers are able to make this a close game again. No real hesitation from Anthony Lynn. They're going to go for two. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Throws left side. And he's got it. They convert for two, and that gets him even closer. Now a two-point game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is taken just shy of the 10. And able to get this out to the 25. Offense set to get this drive started. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. Six-time Pro Bowler Randy Moss, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
That's caught. It's Jerry Rice. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one.
First
down. Not.
They'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. But gutsy call there. Yeggs at the locker room with a lead, tried the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They're already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
Now a throw for the All-Pro Kelsey is complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Give him 15 yards on that one and a Charger first down. Now a give right side. Alexander. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. Dominique Rogers Cromartie up to make the tackle. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. To throw, it's Rogers. Yahoo! And this is intercepted, intended for Hill. Picked off by the safety, D'Angelo Hall. And a return will stop right around the 25. So an opening drive interception to begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spent in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
Yay! He'll rifle this one deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. And he finally is out of bounds. But he's down inside the 20-yard line.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly not so long anymore. One big play, and they're already in field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
Eluding the pressure right. He'll run it. A good response by the defense, sending them backwards after that huge gain last play. 13 yards remaining on 2nd down. Operating from the gun, Gannon. And he is caught at the 7-yard line. And the Raiders are going to have a 1st and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. That is first catch so far. They've held him under wraps, but he's got a first
down there.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Randy Moss. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Raiders add on to their lead.
He was simply incredible at finding the end zone during his tenure in the NFL. Holds the NFL single-season touchdown reception record with 23 back in 2007, partner.
Well, you also reminded me that Randy Moss set the rookie record with 17 touchdown grabs all the way back in 1998.
Well, you remember that season? He felt he had so much to prove to the league. He didn't go as high in the draft as he thought he should have, and he tried to make everyone else pay.
The Charger drive about to get going. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that's quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well and get a few stops.
On play action, it's Rodgers. Complete, the tight end, Kelsey. Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 15 yards on the play, first down. Now a play fake. Rodgers. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he's taken down inside the 30. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Rodgers to throw once more. Flushed out right. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And he's brought down after a very nice game. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's Charger football, but they trail here as we get going in quarter number four. Chargers touchdown. Travis Kelsey there to make the grab. And the Chargers have made this a one-score game.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. They find themselves open for an easy touchdown.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you've got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
They run on first down with Jackson. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing, in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Escaping the pressure right. He's going to drop this off to his fullback. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Looking to throw on second down.
Not.
And he's got his tight end Cook in the end zone. Touchdown, Raiders. Jared Cook there to make the grab. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Now the Raider offense will stay out there as they'll line up to go for two. They'll try and throw for it. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Deion Sanders.
That's an excitement. Right? Go for two. And instead it gets picked off. And how about the return? Give him a lot of credit, though, for not giving up after the play.
Yeah, the
troops rally.
Exactly, and getting back there and making the tackle and not giving up 2 points themselves.
And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going.
Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
On first down, Rodgers. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time, 18 more and a first down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And he's got his man in stride. Complete. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Now a throw here to his running back. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. Flush to his right. That one complete to Hill. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers.
Get over here!
He's got it. Has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the safety, D'Angelo Hall. He's at the 50. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down here to 40-yard line. Here he was saying, hey, give me the football, I'm open, but I don't know if that's a pass that he should have thrown there.
Well, I don't think we've ever met a wide receiver that doesn't think he is open or is about to be open.
True.
So when you throw your hand up in the air and tell your quarterback, hey, I'm available, he's trusting.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Deion Sanders, the Hall of Famer, with a pick. Spectacular this afternoon. Finally, a win for the defense.
You think maybe there was an adjustment there. Finally gained a measure of, I don't even know if you call it revenge, but got a play done against him, and that's been difficult for them all game long.
And this one incomplete. And all that remains is 13 seconds. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Throwing again. Rodgers. Gets this one to Juszczyk. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. One final try for Rodgers. We've seen this before. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football.
And that is GG's in the chat. We're going to go look at the stats a little. They didn't make that big of an impact. I didn't get a pick with Derwin James like I was hoping to, but I did get a sack with Chase Young. He seemed to be in the backfield a couple times. We made some good hits with Derwin James. We got around the field well, so it is what it is. We're going to keep experimenting, get these guys in the right place. But if you haven't, smash that like button, subscribe. And here's going to be two more videos on your right. Check them out. Peace.